The most beautiful presentations of this level of qadr is the hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, which is narrated by Abdul Rahman ibn Auf in Sahih al-Bukhari. In the khilafah of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he was entering into Damascus. He came all the way from Medina to visit the people of Ash-Sham. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant it peace and safety and freedom to its people. Allahumma ameen. And as he comes close to Dimashq, he hears that there's a ta'un, there's a plague, an epidemic, there's an infectious illness that's spreading through the city. So he stops. And he says to the people, هَلْ سَمِعَ مِنْكُمْ شَيْئًا عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا مِنْكُمْ شَيْئًا عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ Did any of you, صلى الله عليه وسلم, hear something from our Messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم, about what to do in a situation like this, where there's an infectious illness? Abdul Rahman ibn Awf, he said, Bala ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Yes, O Amir al-Mu'mineen. Sami'atu al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. If there is a ta'un, if there's an illness in a city, wa antum fiha fala takhruju minha. And you live in the city and everyone's getting sick, don't leave the city. And if you're outside the city, fala tadkhulu. Don't enter it. So Umar ibn al-Khattab wrote to Abu Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah, the Amir of the city, that I'm not coming to visit. And Abu Ubaidah radiallahu anhu, Amin al-Ummah, he wrote a scathing letter to Amir al-Mu'mineen. And he wrote in it what is part, Atafir min qadarillah. Are you trying to escape what Allah has written for you? If Allah wants you to come to the city and die, then this is the qadr of Allah. What makes you think you can escape? So Umar radiallahu anhu wrote, أَفِرُّ مِنْ قَدَرِ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ قَدَرِ اللَّهِ I leave one qadr of Allah to another qadr of Allah. Allahu Akbar. What does this mean? Why is this important? Don't ever think that you're a bystander in your life. Don't ever think you can just sit down on a chair and wait for things to happen. Don't ever think that Allah has taken control of decisions entirely from you. No, Allah has created circumstances and asks you to choose. Inna hadaynahu as-sabil, imma shakiran wa imma kafura. Allah says, I led you to a path where you choose either to be thankful and obedient and worshipping of me, or to be neglectful, ungrateful and disbelieving in me. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ And know that what you will and what you decide and what you choose does not escape the knowledge and the will of Allah. You're not going to choose something Allah doesn't already know. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, we come back to Aqidah. He said that if anyone debates you about the qadr and the knowledge of Allah, فَجَادِلُوهُمْ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ Then ask them about the knowledge of Allah. What do you believe? Do you believe that Allah knows what I will decide before I decide it? And if they say yes, فَهُمْ مُؤْمِنُونَ They're believers. If they say no, فَقَدْ كَفَرْ Our belief is Allah knows my choice. But the choice is determined by the decisions I make from the choices He's given me to choose from.